I'm Mrs. Shweta Ladda, teacher in biology department from Ferguson College. Welcome you all on behalf of the 5th Bharatiya Vigyan Sammelan and Ferguson College, Pune. Now, regarding our session in this Vishwakarma Hall, today's theme is metallurgy, and Dr. Pradeep is our session chairperson. He is the alumnus of IIT Kanpur and University of California, Berkeley. He has worked with Department of Atomic Energy and TRDDC. Just few rules or few briefings to all the speakers. I kindly request all of you switch off your mobiles or keep them on your silent modes. One more request, please do not leave the hall when the speakers are speaking. You wait through the entire session, and kindly ensure that you follow the timing strictly, because as the speakers are less, today we are allotting you more time. 15 minutes is the allotted time. After 13 minutes, I will ring a bell. That will be the warning bell, and you have 2 minutes to complete your speech. So without wasting time, we'll proceed with our session. First speaker for today is Professor S. Jaikishan, and the topic is Wootz production in Northern Telangana, some linguistic issues.
Jaikishan from Hyderabad. I'm not a professor, retired as a reader in history. I'm working as chairman Bhavans Business College. It's an honorary job. So I'm working on iron wood steel industry in Telangana. It's my personal project almost. I had not taken project from any of the organizations. On my own, I did this project. And I did another project, that's cataloging of 4 jeweled iron cannons in ports of North Deccan. Deccan ports, almost all entire Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Part of Maharashtra being covered by my friend Pravin, Deshpande. So we have cataloged the cannons also. That also I'm making a book now. This is almost all hard work. Since 10 years I am doing this. More than 10-12 years, just I'm back of this work. So first of all, I want to acknowledge Professor R. Balasubramaniam, late Professor Balasubramaniam, IIT Kanpur, who was my mentor and guide philosopher in the study of archaeometallurgy. And I dedicated this work to the Smith community, make us a proud India. Urbanization in India, in ancient India, had two distinct phases. The Harappan cities, which emerged in the middle of the 3rd millennia BC, collapsed without leaving any surviving urban centers. On the other hand, the second phase of urbanization emerged and flourished in altogether new socio-economic milieu, generated by the introduction of the iron technology and its extension in the field of production. Here lay the basic difference between the two phases of urbanization, urban growth. So it's called a second phase of urbanization, iron and woods production. India considered as a center for the establishing iron, wood, steel industry in the world. It is probable that the Iron Age in India started about 3,000 years earlier than the West. That time, Hyderabad and Madras in South India were the centers of production of goods. Almost all our quotations taken from various prominent authors. Legendary woods. This advanced material of ancient world had a historical dominance over 3 millennia and geographical sway over 3 continents. Wootz, the legendary metal, as mentioned by a great professor Raghunathan and Sharda Srinivasan, they wrote the book Legendary Wootz Steel, that really inspired me to go ahead with the work. In my book Iron Wootz Industry in Northern Telangana, published in 2009, I mentioned the same thing and acknowledged them also. Wootz was one of the 4 outstanding developments in the long history of metallurgy development in human history. The quote, C.S. Smith. Wootz was a wonderful creation of ancient Indians. Wootz, the quite specific meaning of the very high carbon steel made in small clay crucibles with an indigenous technology. Very wonder. See, as the requirement of the arms increased, the production of the Wootz also increased. So various centers have developed in Telangana. I have witnessed more than 500 sites, 500 villages producing Wootz. But states are quite different again. One site at few sites in Warangal, I have seen most smallest of small crucibles might be weighing at about 50 grams or 30 grams or 100 grams ingots, because in those days archery was prominent in the military. So Kakatiyas were hanged at 9 lakh archers. There is a dominance of the archery. So might be producing in one village, there were at about 24 heaps of crucible slag debris. So now almost all are removed and used for roads. Now remaining a few, only few heaps are remaining now. The iron in Hyderabad at very early period obtained a wide renown, being a fact of material which, when made into steel, afforded the source of supply for the manufacture of Damascus blades. The raw material having been exported to Persia and Punjab for the purpose, I quote Tavernier. Even Thivanaut also came in 1662. He crossed through Hyderabad to Machilipatnam, Machilipatnam to again Surat. On the way, he discovered several industrial sites like Uppalwai, Indalwai, Indur. Indur present Nizamabad district headquarters. That was called as Inumur. Inum means iron. So if you go to the nomenclature of the villages, several villages denoted with the iron production. Inum means iron, slag means chittam, furnace. So these are all Telugu words. With the Telugu words, they named the villages. Means several hundreds of industrial sites were there. The carburation process to harden the iron is being attributed to the ancient world cultures like Greek, Persia and China. But the method they adopted was crude and different from Duncan Wootz process. Certainly the claim of the above cultures may not withstand with present argument. I quote Bala. Because when OSA was in Konasamudram for 3 years, he wanted to know the know-how of the making of Wootz. Even after 3 years, he could not get the knowledge because they did not reveal what they are putting inside the crucible. So when he was in Konasamudram, one Persian trader came to Konasamudram because they used to put an indent at Nizamabad, that's called Indur. When it was not available, they told the trader to go to Konasamudram, the production center. Surrounding Konasamudram, there are several villages producing Wootz, but Konasamudram known as epicenter for the Wootz. Even Aini Akbari also quotes Konasamudram. Several travelers also mentioned about Konasamudram. The total village, present village, existing on the crucibles, debris totally. An inspirational thinking of Niyogi in 1914 is worth mentioning here. We hope we have been able to give a trustworthy account of the process of manufacture of the of Indian steel, which was an object of envy of all nations, but successfully imitated by none, and which supplied the material of many true blades of warriors both in the East and West. It was sad to reflect the ancient indigenous industry which attracted merchants from Persia. Actually, Persians, they almost all owned the trade, because Persian Gulf, total so many cities, they were producing swords. Those swords again vendored in India also. So many sword names also given Persian Gulf names only. In 18th century, European accounts first mentioned of the Wootz, word Wootz. The term first appears in European accounts in 1795 to describe ingots of Eastern and the more particularly Indian crucible steel, when Robert Pearson reported that specimen of Wootz had been sent from Bombay for examination to the Royal Society in London. Those were given to Michael Faraday. Morning, sir, was mentioning. Robert Pearson submitted this paper in Philosophical Transactions also, and he gave some analysis also. A detailed survey was conducted in Telangana region. Iron wood steel production found in more than 2006 villages out of 4,000. I surveyed the almost all 9 districts, excepting Hyderabad city. Out of which, at about 2,600 villages, even now, still more there. So iron was producing, but not the woods. Wood centers were very meager, only in northern part of Telangana, thus Adilabad, Karimnagar, Warangal and Nizamabad, 4 districts. And few parts of the Medak also, few villages in Medak also is covering the woods production. Huge amount of slag and crucible debris and also industrial archaeological evidences related to the manufacture of iron and wood steel implements. This reveals that there still existing the woods using culture. People still use, particularly taddy tappers knives, you find even today woods almost. At least the piece of woods attached to the iron. And they new tree, when they go for cut a new tree for tapping the taddy, so they use new knives. So axes, sickles, so many implements like barber blades, all cutlery items even today you can find. I collected so many, even beetle nut cutters, such things I collected. This wonder metal possibly originated in this region, yet dating tests have to be proved. See, huge heaps of slag, debris. See, sir is standing on the top of that. Brian, they are covering him. So, this is Konapuram, Konasamudram, and Nakalpeta, some of the villages. Konasamudram, a renowned village where they dug out for constructing a house, total is full of crucibles. So, all these crucible sites. Now, I will show you the ingot. This wood's ingot. This is ours and the rivers. Downside that's when consultation takes place, there will be a pogrom, a cat eye. Oh, 2 minutes, okay. The technique of producing woods, Damascus steel blades is the last art. I quote, the date of the last blade produced, he mentioned about 1750, John Warhaven, is likely that blade display low quality Damascus patterns were produced later than the early 19th century. Date has been persisting in the metallurgy community over past 200 years as to how the blades were made, why the surface patterns appeared. Shusra Samhita mentioned about surgical blades making with white iron. The word woods is a corruption of the basic word ukku in Telugu, that's melt or boil. This in Tamil, urukku, Kannada, ukku. The same words, because Kannada Adigayu Pampa belongs to Karimnagar district, and so many Kannada inscriptions, Kannada Telugu bilingual inscriptions also find there. So this is nothing but this word went to Karnataka. The several inscriptions of Kannada and Telugu are found in the region. So the word Ukku might be popular in both the languages. Alkindi described that the steel made in India was called as a mahannar, that was made in a small clay crucibles. The word fowler means the purified, as explained by Alkindi. This word was found as pulat. For instance, Cordian, who called this product pulat, johandar, acid onde, which means watering steel. A characteristic of what was, if this, at least I did not complete. Just you can go through this. Wootz was known as Ferrum Candem by Pliny, Onenic by Marco Polo, Hinduvani by Arabs, and Persian they say it Pulat, Folat. Folat is a Urdu word also. Metal is known by the name Telugu, Tilang, as described by OSA. To quote Arab accounts, also point to the nephem of the Telang steel, which can be taken to refer the origin of the Telangana in Andhra Pradesh in southwestern India. Golconda was very famous, and I want to quote Shukraniti also. Shukraniti, Ayurveda books like Tikshana Munda. Tikshana Loha is nothing but Wootz, as mentioned by Rasarnava, Rasanatna Sulhakara, Rasajalanidhi, Rasa, Rasaratna Samuchaya, Rasarnava. Ghara, Sara, Hrunnala, these six varieties of steel was mentioned by Rasatna Samuchaya. Verse 78 describes about the Vajra Tikshana Loha, thus fine variety of Wootz. How it was manufactured? It was blasted, made in a clay crucibles, and kept it in and kept for greening. After greening 24 hours, they put in a furnace and blasted for 24 hours. After taking out, 12 hours for kept for greening. So these are all the crucibles. Iron implements, even still, you can found these implements with the smiths. Several, see, the huge ingot I will show you, this 20 kg ingot. So modern smith sites, smith workshops now. This is my collection. Iron Wootz industry was highly prevalent in Telangana. Wootz steel industry was predominant, and its associated weapon industry expanded due to high demand in the country and the foreign and from the external traders. These occupational groups, customs and rituals are still continuing in some areas. The smiths families follow the customs, but so most of the people in the modern days do not know about the goddess Mammai and the traditions and the Wootz culture. Thank you. The due acknowledgement to the organizers, professors, scholars. Thank you.
Privileged to be here to just give you an insight into the ancient casting technologies and modern methods of fingerprinting. Well, the structure of my talk is something like this. One slide about my organization, from where I come from. A peep into the ancient lost wax process, which we got an opportunity to go and study in a place called as Swami Malai near Tanjavur or Kumbakonam, where even today this process is being practiced. And then we have been given the opportunity to fabricate this tallest Nataraja by the Department of Atomic Energy, which was done by the traditional lost wax process, and something related to what are the advanced technologies that are available. Just one or two slides. How these technologies can be used for fingerprinting as well as for restoration or conservation purposes. And some sort of thoughts I thought I can just dwell upon. Well, I come from the Department of Atomic Energy, Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, Kalpakkam, which is the second largest R&D unit, which is located about 60 kilometers from Chennai, adjacent to the famous World Heritage Site Mahabalipuram, and in between Mahabalipuram and Pondicherry. This is a unique complex because it is here we have three different kinds of reactor systems. We have a natural uranium-based pressurized heavy water reactor. We have the first of its kind fast reactor, fast beta test reactor, utilizing a combination of uranium carbide and plutonium carbide. And we have the only possible reactor in the world which uses uranium-233 as a fuel. And this reactor is being utilized for all the pyro devices, qualification and examination of the pyro devices, which are used in practically all the space launch vehicles, satellites, etc. It's qualified using the Kamini reactor, Kalpakkam mini reactor, and then it goes to Sriharikota for integration. Well, some of the spin-off technologies, we have been using it for societal applications, and our interaction started when Dr. Paramasivam, Dr. Professor Ranganathan had mentioned this name during his inaugural talk. He was a frail old man, about 68 years old, when he came to Kalpakkam, roughly in about 87 or 88. I was a young boy of about 24 years. And his passion for idols, icons, and this particular area